Hello to my Leos. This is Queen Amun Ra coming to you with your general reading. All right, Leos, let's get right into it. All right, so this reading is for the 26th of August through the 2nd of September. 2nd of September kicks off the first, a whole new cycle, right? So you want to make sure you focus on this week closing out of cycles. And what did you learn? How did you become a better human being? How did you become a better humanitarian? We had a full moon in Aquarius. It was a surging moon. We had a blue moon, a super blue moon. We had a harvest, it was called harvest moon, sturgeon moon, thunder moon, right? What was your awakening about yourself in terms of breaking generational cycles, chains, and curses? Generational cycles, chains, and curses. All right. All right, all right, all right. Let's see. Let's see what's in your cards. All right. I already prayed over your cards. Somebody's moving on in childlike faith, maybe after lamenting over some things. See if we can make this a little easier for somebody. All right. Because something brought out the high priest and high priestess energy in you. Something woke somebody up. All right, Leos, let's get it. This is a general reading, so take only what resonates with you. If you're interested in a personal reading, my information is down below in the description. Here we have the Six of Cups. Somebody's moving on from something. Having childlike faith. Here we have the Five of Cups here. And we also have the Four of Cups here, right? Lots of emotion, some kind of emotional attachment to something. It could be somebody that you love, whether it's kids or whether it's emotional attachment. Somebody that you were created. Something you created some kind of a bond with, emotional bond with. Let's just put it that way. But you made it to your throne. Here we have the King of Wands. You made it to your throne, right? Operating in childlike faith. A lot of your wishes are being fulfilled in terms of your spiritual journey, your intuition, your, remember, water is shaped and guided by the earth that holds and surrounds it. So it makes a difference who you're around. Are you around people who pray for people? And I'm not talking about coming under the guise of prayer. We're not talking about titles. We're talking about, are you around people who pray for people, or are you around people who pray on people? There's a big difference. You don't always have to physically see it when your spirit knows something. You feel something. Something woke up the high priestess in you. Something happened with somebody who had an emotional connection. Something woke up the high priestess in you that somebody was being preyed upon. Somebody that you created some kind of an emotional attachment or bond with was being preyed upon, right? Something woke you up. Think about it. Something woke you up. It could have been a love interest that was being preyed on that you didn't know. It could have been a family member, relative. It could have been a really good friend. Somebody was being preyed upon. And as long as you stayed in high priest mode, which deals with the material aspect of things, you would have never listened to your feelings until something woke you up. What was that something? You have to decide what the something is, Leos, because sometimes the something is somebody cutting you off, right? Here we have the number six. This number six is in the shape of a person who has a rounded back and a bulging belly, right? Something woke you up about your child, someone else's child. It could be your own inner child. Something woke you up to say, okay, if I have an emotional attachment to something, that water is flowing through. Like there's the emotion connected to something, whether it was fear, doubt, uncertainty, sexuality, sensuality, joy, pain, feelings, emotions, your intuition. High priestess, access to the unknown, something woke you up about somebody being in a predatory environment, right? That's why I always tell people, don't jump to conclusions about people. Don't jump to conclusions about people. Don't assume when you get into a relationship with people, you're so busy trauma bonding, you know, I got one upper, you know, you're trying to save people. That's why I said, take the cape off. When you sit down and listen, pay attention, be in receiving mode and hear what somebody's saying through their emotions. If they're crying to you and they are mad or frustrated, don't continue to pray on somebody when they're going through something. That's what I'm saying. Something had to wake somebody up to say, okay, all of this jumping to conclusions and I know all of this and I know and I heard this and that. That is very toxic. So it's just trying to help somebody with divine feminine energy, really pulling out the high priestess in you, as well as the high priest. Yeah, you can physically look at something and think you assume something. Why is this person drinking so much? Why is this person eating so much? What's wrong with them? Why are they under some kind of, I can tell they're under some kind of influence. What is going on with them? Something about why are they so hypersexual? Why are they so rigid when it comes to sex? Why are they so closed off when it comes to intimacy in any way, their emotions? Why are they so shut down when I talk about certain things? So it's just trying to help somebody to start paying attention. That's what this is right here. That is what this is right here. So that you don't become a predator. So that you don't become that person who's preying on somebody who is crying out and asking you for help for something. And you're so busy saving everybody else, you can't slow down to see something yourself. So when I see you moving on in childlike faith and connecting, having emotional connections with loved ones that are, this is what's going to put somebody in a calmer headspace. A lot of people don't ask, you know, when they're entering into a relationship with somebody, because I'm creating some kind of an emotional bond. Here we have the strength card. Somebody has been in wilderness situation their whole life, right? In survival mode, practically their whole life. Survival just going from here to here to here. Source needs you to be in meekness. Right here, see this right here? Half lion, half human with sheep, right? Source needs you to be meek and let Source fight your battles. Because if you run into save everybody, I got to go put on my cape and I got to race out there with my arms out like super person, super Leo. I got to go out there and save everybody. You miss very important things that people have been in survival mode their whole life. Somebody feel like, okay, they're creating some kind of an emotional bond with you. The last thing people need when somebody is around. Remember, water is shaped and guided by the earth that holds and surrounds it, right? The last thing people need is for you to leave a presence of an energy that has gone into, who has opened up to you and shared something with you, to go back into your own wilderness situation and be in survival mode and use what they share in hurt and pain against them. That's the last thing that people need. Source needs you on your throne. Something has put you on your throne. Source needs you on your throne praying for people, not being in the dark side of lion energy, which is in survival mode. Soon as somebody pour out to you and you see that's a wound, they crying, they pouring out to you about something that happened and so on and so forth. Somebody says, you know, when they get mad, going to the dark side of Leo, competition, judging, comparing. Well, my life wasn't like that. Well, you should have done, and start judging their family or judging X, Y, and Z, because it puts them deeper into survival mode. Now I can't trust you. You just talked about my mom. You just talked about my dad. You just talked about my family. You just talked about something. I opened up and I shared something with you, and you're attacking everybody that I have an emotional tie with, right? So Source is trying to help somebody to learn how to, this is not a competition. Water is mirroring energy, meaning that this is a new agreement that somebody is signing with themselves. We're talking about like this, the new agreement that you're signing with yourself. When I look in this mirror, this is what this cycle of humanitarian is about. This is going to make you once in a blue moon rare. When I look in the mirror and what I see looking back at me is a person to encourage people to come out of survival mode. So if they're in, somebody's in survival mode, and that's my assignment to help people to come out of survival mode, I'm not even the last person that's going to pray on them. I am not praying on them at all. I am praying for them. I don't need to know everything that they've gone through. That takes levels to get to that. I don't need to know every little thing they went through. I don't need to come with the solutions. All I need to do is sit there and listen. Listen, listen, listen. Be in receiving mode. Somebody has been in survival mode, right? The last thing they need to do is be attacked by the people that they've created an emotional bond with. Their mom, their dad, their family, their this and that, friends. They don't need to be attacked. They don't need to be put in further survival mode. Like, let me take you away. Let me save you. Let me take you away from that. What they need is empowerment. Source is teaching somebody how to use their fire, Leo. Source is teaching you that your fire can help people to feel powerful, confident, strong-willed, motivated, like a leader, and have mental clarity, especially if they've been in environments where it's caused them to have digestive issues, kidney or liver problems, which you can kind of probably sort of see, but, you know, physically see it on some people. Food allergies, rage, or for them to feel like they're timid, like you'll be able to see all of this. You'll have a feeling that something, they're in survival mode. Chronic fatigue, you know, whether they've been around narcissistic energies, if they have low self-esteem. And that's why I keep telling y'all, Leos, stay in your light. You are ruled by the sun. It's very powerful. The sun is medicine. So if the sun is medicine and you're ruled by the sun, it has to be this clear for somebody. If you all are ruled by the sun, and the sun is medicine, why would you be poison to anybody that is in survival mode? Well, you can pray. The other option is for you to pray for them. Take one of them wishes that you want fulfilled and say, I pray that everybody that's in survival mode, thank you, Source, that everybody that's in survival mode, who has been bullied, who have been victims of narcissism, who have, you know, food allergies and ulcers and liver issues and stuff as a result of them living in fear practically their whole life, having low self-esteem, people who have been the victim of people who have been enraged or caused them to be timid or anything where they're fired, where people are trying to extinguish their flame, their light inside of them. Thank you, Source, that they are out of these wilderness situations. Thank you that they're out of these situations. Source is going to pull this out of you regardless. Leo, I can tell you that right now. Source is going to pull the meekness out of you. Because operating in this, when somebody gets upset, and I'm just going straight on like the lion that sits like an apex predator sits and gets on those legs real low, because as soon as somebody turn their back, you feel like somebody has rejected or turned their back on you. What does the lion do? Pounce, right? But Source is like, bam, I'm going to put a block right there. I'm going to stop this. I'm going to stop this. I'm going to break that. That's what Source is doing. Source has to break that. However it needs to get through. However it needed to get through. So, Source is like, something about your energy has been in survival mode, whether you've been preyed upon or loved ones have been preyed upon. Somebody doesn't get the message until however Source needs to get the message through to you. You're not trying to add to people's emotional wounding. That's what this is. Find out what your Chiron is. It's currently retrograde. Chiron. Chiron. The link for Chiron is below. Oh, but they caused me some emotional wounding, you know, as it relates to, you know, something of value to me. And I got to get the sources. Like, if you're not seeing the light in people, seeing the light, operating in the light, and you're obsessed with that, I guarantee you, energies that's in survival mode, there's always somebody who is vying for the top spot. Y'all need to watch the Animal Channel. There's somebody who is vying for the top spot, and that puts you directly in the line of another predator. And you can't see, you won't even see it coming. You won't even see it coming because that's the whole element of predatory energy, the sneak attack. It'll sneak up on you. Next thing you know, you just in a situation, you just like, what the heck? How come I didn't see that coming? It can come in a form of a bill that you completely forgot about. It can come in a form of anything that you just sneak attack. So source is saying somebody needs to wake up for real. Somebody really needs to wake up. That's why I said take that cape off. Stop trying to save everybody. You got to be racing here and there because people are waking up from some nightmares. You are waking up from some nightmares. Don't invoke any more on yourself and other people. Somebody is just now waking up to some nightmares like, oh my God. But that's what puts somebody in survival mode, Leos. If you had never been around energy vampires and it was balanced out and balance was encouraged in your family, this is when you break in this generational cycle, change, and curse. If balance was encouraged in your family, you would have never been put in survival mode. Somebody didn't believe something you told them. Somebody put you in some kind of situation. Something somebody said between the ages of 8 years old and 14. Something. And so source is saying to you, something put you in survival mode. And so that's why somebody kind of lost sight. Somebody could have been sitting right in front of you, you know, sick to their stomach, just like everything coming up. And somebody would have been like, wouldn't even question, oh, why are they drinking so much? Why are they so sick? Why they always got to stay plastered? What in the world? That's survival mode. They're trying to forget something. What is going on? Breakthrough. They've been around a bunch of hurt people who like to hurt other people. It could be a geographical location where they live in. Remember, water is shaped and guided by the earth that holds and surrounds it. I'm telling you, Leo, source is going to make sure you stay on that throne. Every time you step down off that throne and you don't balance it out, they put you in a survival mode. We're not each other's saviors. If you know why you're here on planet Earth and you embody both this and this, and source is saying you brought high priest and high priestess energy, and you put another human being in survival mode. It doesn't matter what you think they did to you. If you put them in survival mode, source is saying you're putting yourself direct prey to something else. Somebody's going to have to come out of that mindset. Six of Pentacles. Some kind of money is coming. Something of value is coming across your path. You being sources say, I'm sending money coming across your path. Some money is coming across your path. Yeah. See, that's the thing that a lot of people, that's all they see. Somebody did something to me and I got to do something back to somebody else. Mm-mm. Survival mode. Remember, it's always survival of something. So you feel like, okay, you got instant gratification from something, right? And source says, stand down. Source says, no, pray for them. But you said, no, I'm going to feel better if I just go into the dark side of lion energy. Source says, no, I need you to pray for them. I need you to pray for them. Let me handle something. I need you to break that infinite negative cycle, way of thinking, that emotion. I need to get away from you. Stop drinking the poison. All this right here. Stop drinking the poison. Stop taking the poison. Stop the venomous. Stop that. So let's see what we got going on here. Let's see what else we got. Yeah, you're heavy on some people's minds, but do not go back in that direction. No matter what, don't go back in that direction. Page of Cups, right? Here's this right here. The pig with wings. You have some good news coming across your path. And if you go back to that emotion in any way, shape, form, or fashion, and you mirror, that's because when you look in the mirror, you say, well, I see a lion when I look in the mirror. And that lion, that cat is going to come out. And that cat is going to, that's just what I see in the mirror, right? You say, that's what I see when I look in the mirror. But you don't see it inside of you. Source fighting your battles. You see it on the outside. You see your hair with lion hair all wild. And you got the big old claws about to pounce on something. But what you won't see is something coming up behind you. So it says move on. Move on from something. You got some good news trying to come in. You got some good news. You got some good news coming in. Somebody could have new love coming in. It could be a new baby. It could be a new job. It could be a new something new is coming across your path. Here we have the Star card. Your star in your own right. There's hope, optimism, and also something coming across your path. So some kind of new source is trying to create some kind of new emotional bond with you, between you and something you may have felt like caused you to step down off of your throne and put you in a survival mode situation. Source is trying to help somebody, but if again somebody is operating in survival mode, you're only hurting yourself. I'm telling you, you're only hurting yourself. That can cause a person to a sneak attack. The enemy comes in. Next thing you know, your marriage is in shambles. Anything could happen. Next thing you know, somebody that you feel like I plan on buying, such and such, somebody could lose their job. I mean, it just happens in so many different ways because the enemy is always in the details. The devil is always in the details. Always like, if you do this, then I can promise you that, right? I feel like if somebody had, you know, in talking in terms of like relationships, when you're talking to people and you're creating emotional bonds with people, ask them how they feel about their loved ones, because it's going to be an indicator in how they're going to treat you in some way, shape, form, or fashion, because you're going to see it right then and there. If they resent and hate certain people and they're not telling you certain things and they're telling you that vain and vengeful, you see that vain and vengeful spirit come out towards somebody, you can guarantee it, it's going to come out on you eventually. You can guarantee it's going to come out on you because you're seeing something and you thinking, I'm in survival mode. Remember, survival, you think in survival of the fittest. I can survive this. And they told you out of their mouth at their when they were pouring out to you what they would be willing to do to somebody they have an emotional bond to. I could such and such that person. I could such and such and such and such. And you sitting there just listening. Not even moved, because again, somebody could have some kind of a, you know, like I said, if you're on the dark side of lion energy, this is before you got to your throne. And they say, I hate so and so. You sit right there and listen, because that default with the fire, it has to be something rubbing together in order to start a fire. That's judging, that's comparison, that is conflict, all of that, right? It's that. It's all of that, right? So now you mad with them. You mirroring that same spirit. Now you just mirrored that same, because you forgot when you looked in the mirror who you were. So you just mirrored, you just took on their karma. You just mirrored that spirit of rage, frustration, and anger. That timid spirit, that survival mode. If I'm ever, my back is against the wall, I'm in survival mode. You just took on that same situation. You took on that same energy. When source says, listen, I need you to be meek. Let me handle a situation. Sit yourself on the throne. Adjust your crown. Take the cape off. If somebody told you, somebody that you may have been connected to has a rage in them that will put you in survival mode. What they're saying to you, what their spirit is telling you, is if you ever put me in, if it's between me and you, no matter what the situation is, and this is what somebody is not seeing, if it's between me and you, and I got to choose me to survive, and that means throwing you under a bus, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Source is going to break somebody out of this. I got to go say, I'm so busy saving everybody. I'm so drained. I can't listen to my own intuition, the voice of Source inside of you. Trying to help you, Leos. So if you belong to any organizations or anything that puts you in survival mode, and Source has been telling you to leave the organization, whether it's a job, whatever organization, right? That's a job, whatever. Just look up the word organization, y'all, for clarity, and also listen to the inner voice of Source telling you. exactly what to leave behind that keeps you in survival mode, that you may have drank the poison so much it may be running through your veins that you don't even see, that you can't even tell when other people are in survival mode, when source is getting using you to stand out, not fit in, so that you can lead the way it was always intended for you to lead. Here's the Four of Wands here. Yep. So something is happening. Somebody has new and exuberant love coming in their lives. You got some good news coming across your path. So source saying, take a leap of faith, leap forward, not fall back into that same misery loves company. Don't fall back into the fire, right? Something is complete. It's already complete. That's the number 7. 4 and 3 is 7. On the dark side of the number 7, somebody is still asking why. Enraged, upset, frustrated. Source is saying something is complete. You had your tower moment. That's your awakening. Get into your purpose. This is right here, King of Wands. Pray for people. You're going to feel very fortunate that you chose to pray for people and not join the other energies that have prayed on them. Two of Pentacles. So yeah, so somebody has been around energies who are, it's two energies that have been masking whatever lifestyle they're in. They're living beyond their means, right? So they really cannot, they are trying to keep up with the Joneses. You all are familiar with that term. They're trying to keep up with the Joneses, and source is trying to help you balance things out. And we see like, and so a lot of time has been spent on this emotion about something. Sexuality, sensuality, we're talking about water, emotions, feelings, something. I have a feeling about something. I believe this and I desire that, all of this. And so I need you to go by somewhere by yourself and tap into the living water. That means flush all of that toxic mess out. Go deep. Flush all that toxic mess out and start thinking in terms of collaboration, not judging, comparing, and competing. How can I collaborate where things are just flow? When I'm saying I want to be in spaces where things flow and I want to create in spaces where they flow, when I'm trying to encourage warm conversation, I'm trying to encourage a fireside chat, not a wildfire, where energies don't want to be around you and then ego takes over. Oh, they just jealous. They see me as competition. Come on now. Listen, there's more than one Leo on the planet, right? So everybody can't be jealous of everybody. Everybody's not envious. Everybody is not. That was edging God out. That's ego, right? When you can look in the mirror and the light in you from the creator, you see it in another human being. This entire cycle is about humanitarianism. It's all about, I see the God in you just like I see the God in me. I see greatness and purpose in you just like I see greatness and purpose in me. So no matter what other people's demons that they're hosting, because trust and believe, whatever demons they're hosting, they're the host with the most or the hostess with the mostest, right? So it's just saying to you, you're still seeing the light in the inside of them. You said, okay, I see the light in other, because I know I see God in me when I look in the mirror every single day. So there's nothing that somebody can do to cause me to go back into the dark side of lion energy. And so if you're on that frequency, if I get mad, hair flying all over the place, and I black out all, I want you to right now, after you watch this video, go to the zoo where you live and jump inside, you know what I'm saying? Like, think to yourself, if you went to a zoo, don't do this now, just so we're clear, but you've seen videos of people who jump inside of a lion's cage. Do you honestly think that you, as in human form, would stand a chance against a real lion? Absolutely. Now, you're talking about survival mode and how fast they are. Soon as you turn your back, they go right into apex. They already an apex predator. They, in trust, they're not as small as people think when you look at them on television. Source said, come up out of that toxic environment, way of thinking, that toxic emotion. That toxic emotion, the Seven of Cups, because there's too much temptation to go back to something, of an emotion. When source is saying, I need you to be in meek mode, not weakness mode. Weakness would be like you're in survival mode. come out of that mindset. Somebody has been preyed upon in some way, shape, form, or fashion, and you being reactive will add to that predator list. Here we have Queen of Pentacles here. Adjust your crown. Adjust your crown. That's the beauty of making emotional connections with people and maybe gaining some deeper level of understanding. Like, what's going on here? You know, like, what is the saying? You know, people like when people are operating, like I said, it comes across as disingenuous. You can tell when a person who is in survival mode, you can tell in their eyes when they're in survival mode. Like, oh, not that you would go and try to pet a lion on the top of his head. There's plenty of people who have, there's this guy, I can't think of his name. He's on, a lot of his reels pop up on YouTube where he has trained lions and hyenas and, you know, he's trained wild animals. And even the ones that, like, approach him lovingly, like they want their head rubbed and things like that, the average person would not get into that space with those animals because their instinct is to just, like I said, if they smell blood, like if one of them lions just nicked this person or something, blood, they're not coming with a kit. They're not coming with the first aid kit. They're not coming with the first aid kit. So source is saying before you judge any energy looking at your cards here, that's something you want to break because it's also an emotion to judge or be judged. Well, you judging me based on, so I'm judging you based on yours, right? Again, comparison. And if you're trying to create water, if you're trying to create something with somebody, you're trying to create, you're saying, okay, source, I prayed for some good news to come across my path. And you got all these temptations here, all of these temptations here to vibrate on a lower frequency. Usually you see like a snake, you know, or whatever. Somebody is having an awakening, a spiritual awakening or kundalini experience where the scales have been removed from your eyes. That every time you go into survival mode and you come up out of that, then worse happens. Something worse happens. So sources say you are not a apex predator, not in that sense, you know, like humans can be, but you know, you're not in that sense where you're reactive. Like you, somebody turn their back or they reject you, or you feel like somebody turned their back on you in any way, I'm gonna go pounce and attack them. Sources saying because somebody put you in a situation where you were in survival mode. Sources say you stay on your that's a cycle that's complete. Whenever you feel like somebody turned their back or rejected you in some way, shape, form, or fashion, okay, not a problem. I'm keeping my vibrations high because my attitude is going to determine my altitude. I'll pray for them. I may not know the full story, but I'm not going to pray on them by telling this person, hanging something over their head. I got all this dirt on somebody and I can use it against them. I'm not all of that. I keep trying to tell people, Pluto being retrograde, Pluto is not only the planet of power and transformation. Everybody is going through a transformation. Everybody, every human being, the whole planet is being reset. Right? That's Pluto. Source is saying everybody who is going through a powerful transformation and trying to go through a metamorphosis and make something make sense to them, their sexuality, their sensuality, their creativity, their emotions, their feelings, their subconscious habits, listening to their intuition. Everybody is going through a cycle. Everybody's going through phases within a cycle of their lives. And none of us can rush a person to get to maybe where you are on your journey. Take the cape off. Take the cape off because you end up making something worse. So it's time to expand your brand. Yep. Somebody's an incubus. Somebody is an incubus. Somebody, like I said, sex demon. They have been around some kind of sex demons, and they've been infected by drinking that poison. Basically, somebody's like, oh, no, have as much sex as you want to. That's the spirit. That's how, and their cure would be celibacy. So you coming in saying, here, drink this, or let's have a wild night of such and such, when somebody has a demon that's attached to them, and people want to feed that demon that's attached to them, a simple conversation with someone that they are emotionally connected to, that they told you that they love and they, you know, or have some kind of emotional attachment to, you would have found that out. It's all becoming clear. You would have found something out. You would have found something. That's why I keep telling people, stop jumping to conclusions. Stop jumping to conclusions. Everybody not cheating on everybody. Some people are in environment. Their water is in environments that's feeding their demons. Here, if you just drink this, you can go out and sleep with as many people as you want to. Nobody's considering them being the spiritual demons that are attached to them that's making things worse. They start out with one demon, okay? They more demons, whatever they can host, whatever their body can host, gluttony, sex, drugs, alcohol, whatever their body can host. Source is saying you don't want to pray on them. You want to pray for them. Because you don't know where it all started. That's what Source is trying to help somebody. Well, something had to wake you up out of something. Your mental health is just as important as your physical health, but so is everybody else's. Take a leap of faith. You have the gift of clairaudience. That's clear listening. Your ancestors have a message. You inspire some people to heal. That's why I said, close out a cycle in love. Keep your vibrations high. Operate in meekness. Don't be spreading people's business all over. But I was just trying to gain some clarity. I had to ask this question, answer, and steadily praying on. That's what you call when people come under the guise of prayer. That is not sincere at all. The guise of prayer. So they got to find out every little thing that's going on with the person. Next thing you know, it's spread all over an organization. But they asked me to pray for them, and you know, they just really going through it right now. They going through this and that and this and that. You just became the predator. Just like somebody did to you. You just prayed on someone's their emotions. That's what I mean by predator. You prayed on them crying to you, opening up to you, exposing a side to themselves that they felt like it was a safe space. So, just like someone did to you. So, when does the cycle stop? It stops with you. It stops with you. You're not in competition with anybody. Start doing the mirror work. Start doing the mirror work. You made a positive impact on some people. Start doing the mirror work. You already have enough people running around here with titles, hurting people, coming under the guise of prayer. But what exactly are we praying for? All I need you to do is just stand in agreement with what I already prayed to Source for. Why you need to know what's going on. So Source is trying to tell somebody, like, you know, somebody may have had a nervous breakdown, right? Somebody may have had a nervous breakdown because they're just now waking up from all of the... If you want to align yourself with people who can help, can really, really help, come out of that competitive mindset. Come out of that. You're going to have to come into collaboration mode and say, okay, maybe I need to pick up the phone and call somebody that they felt like was close to them or nurturing to them. Maybe I need to call somebody to help me understand or help me with something. Because maybe my information and their information working together, we can collaborate and get some help going on here. But I'm telling you, this is Source chose you, whoever's tuning into this, to break that negative cycle of that emotion. I'm mad because somebody else mad, and I'm going right into the dark side of lion energy. Source is trying to help you to build healthy, divine relationships with people, trying to help you align your, you say you really love somebody, Source is saying, okay, Source is trying to help you to build aligned relationships that help get people out of survival mode. But if you see certain people as competition, then you just took yourself completely out of a situation where your head and heart still are at war with each other because you're focused on the wrong things. I bring positive energy into my life. We're talking about encouraging, inspiring people to be, you know, to get the strength That's your strength card. You're inspiring people to get the strength to leave these survival mode situations. You're in survival mode. So if that means that, hey, you dating somebody and you feel like they're in the wrong environment because they're in survival mode all the time, and your mind could be like, oh, they cheating on me. They got all these temptations around them. They probably doing this and that. Please come out of that. There's so many people that's in, this right here lets me know that you connected to somebody that's in survival mode. Come out of that. Please come out of that. You're going to do more damage. You're going to do more damage. So that's what Source is trying to help somebody learn how to do, is learn how to collaborate. So in their time of opening up to you, they're telling you stuff, right? And so you're going into, okay, let me put on my thinking cap. What do we have in common so I can make sure that you're giving people the strength, you know, to leave survival mode situations? If it's younger kids, okay, let me pour some ideas into their mind to help them leave survival mode situation. They're ever in a situation, they're about to be bullied, they're this and that. I'm helping them to learn how to say, okay, I don't feel safe in this environment. I can leave this environment. Source is trying to put you in collaboration with somebody. And again, Source is saying that, you know, you can't be flowing with ego with that. Here we have meditate and contemplate. So this is where the compassion comes in. This is where compassion comes in. Just like you be pouring compassion into yourself, you're the energy you desire to attract. So if you want to attract people who are compassionate towards people that's in situations, and they got to use their mind and help people get out of these situations, you just can't go in there like gangbusters. You can't just go bust down, kick down a door, and just be in survival mode, because somebody will be waiting for you that's vying for a top spot. They in survival mode too. You got to use your wisdom. That's what I see happening this week. You're using your wisdom, coming out of that survival mode, a competition. I can save this. But no, you think that. That's very humbling. Very humbling to think anybody can save anybody. We're not each other's gods. Somebody emotionally has somebody that you have an emotional connection with, whether you dated them, it could be your kids, it could be loved ones or whatever, they are under some kind of control of energies that are vain and vengeful and agreeing with envy with everybody. So they treat everybody that's connected to them like they're their property. That's why I need y'all to wake up, Leos. Wake up. Wake up. Sacrifice. Yeah. So sometimes surrender is painful. God's cutting away all that needs to go. Illusions, obsessions, addictions. It's a sacrifice to love. You don't know who has been sacrificed. Right? And so Source is saying, cut away all of that. Cut away all of that toxic, you know, poisonous, venomous something that you've been bit with that keeps you, and when we say the Seven of Cups, that keeps you from allowing the scales to be removed from your eyes. That's what I'm saying for you all. I am adventurous. So you have a zest for life, and you are eager to experience anything and everything possible. You love change and excitement, and you need both to feel truly alive. For you, life is an adventure to be lived. Life is an adventure to be lived. So Source needs somebody to busy their time instead of somebody just looking for, you know, somebody calls some kind of wounding, and I want some money. I just want money. Source is saying, think about focusing on, one, getting from around energies that are living beyond their means. That's first and foremost. That's first somebody needed to, because that's contaminating your water. That's very toxic. Being around that snake energy, right? That energy where there's a poisonous environment. So snakes can be poisonous or venomous, right? So depending on how long you've been around people who are, you know, live, you know, like I said, trying to live, they all image driven. It's all about what they, with the labels they got on this and that, how, what zip code they live in, all this. Get from around those people, because I'm telling you, Source is putting you on your throne and adjusting your crown. That's what Source is doing for somebody. And so that's the first order of business. I need to get from around those types of spirits to become a better human being. Because in the big scheme of things, it's never all about just the material. It cannot be about the material world if you're saying that you have high priestess energy. I'm talking to men and women. That's intuition. Your intuition is, it can never be about that. So it's just saying, you're taking a quantum leap into your own future. What you see in your own future is somebody who is down to earth, someone who is relatable. You can relate to something, right? Something about being put in, being around the water, being in certain spaces, and that water being contaminated, causing people to drink, be on medication, all this other stuff. You can relate to certain things. I'm telling you, Source is trying to put together a collaboration here. Source, it's a divine collaboration. That's what Source is trying to put, help somebody with. So, want to come out of that mode, that survival mode. Here we have love. Love is an endless well. It always has been. It always will be. I go free to be kind, loving, and courageous. I'm so thankful that the relationships in my life greatly exceed my wildest imaginations. The first order of business, get from around people who are, you know, who are trying to keep up with the Joneses. That's all they talking about is they live in this zip code, and this person don't have this, and they don't have that, and it's just, it's a bunch of smoke and mirrors, which is another form of water, right? They're mirroring this image. It's smoke. Smoke is a form of water, right? That's steam, right? That steam come in the form of ice. So you don't really know what kind of emotion you're going to get from some people. Sometimes they feel like icy emotions. Sometimes it feels like steam being let off, right? And so whatever it is, it's causing emotional wounding. So this is not, I got to get back at somebody, you know, who said something to me, or it's not that. Source is saying it's time to sit on your throne and pray for people, for real. It's time to sit on your throne and pray for people, because a collaborative effort is being put together directly by Source, and that you need to pay attention. Because somebody, some kind of sacrifice is happening here. Some kind of sacrifice is happening here. So Source is saying it's better for obedience is better than sacrifice. Obey what Source is trying to tell you. And I'm not your Source, obviously. I'm not your God, nor anybody's God. But Source is trying to tell you, you need to go tap in. You need to go sit down somewhere and flush all of this, whatever it is, out, so that Source can use you in a very meek way to align yourself with somebody who is, you know, who you're around in a predatory environment. That's being like, could be some kind of a sacrificial lamb for something. So it's just time to help somebody. That's it. You say you want these divine connections. That's what Source is trying to put in somebody's face right there. You got to keep your vibrations high. Come away with it. Well, nobody helped me, so I gotta do for myself. All of that out the window. It has to be out of the window. We're talking about other human beings here. Do the mirror work. That is what I'm seeing for you all, Leos. In terms of giveaways, like I mentioned before, the one that we had on August 22nd is over, because that was a Leo/Virgo cusp giveaway. We're doing more giveaways. If you want to watch Virgo videos, there's also something on the community page. We have a person who was generous enough who she did it this year again. Last year she did it, but she did it again this year. 1 hour energy session. I think it either 30 minutes or 1 hour energy sessions. The people who have already had them felt like they were phenomenal. The information is on my community page and they're free. You don't have to pay a dime for it. So look it up. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to be a Virgo to receive it. She's open to whoever, but people who have had her sessions have been, you know, very, very pleased. So that may be something somebody could look into as well. But we're always doing giveaways. But in this case right here, Source is going to break some. Source has been breaking somebody out of this competition mode. Like, you got to find a better half. So you got to be, I got to be the good person. Somebody got to be the bad person in a situation. No, no, no. It's seeing light, God's light in everybody. And saying, okay, I want to collaborate with people to help people come out of a wilderness situation. They are not my competition at all. Nobody's your competition. That's what I have for you all. And I will see you all in the next reading. But that's what I have for this week for you all. Like I said, from the 26th through the 2nd of September, this is what I have for you. All right? Bye.